word problems with division of multi-digits, a la Shmoop. All right, well, if you're anything like us, you love word problems. It's so nice to be reminded that math is something that actually has some application in the real world rather than just a jumbled mess of numbers and letters. That said, well, they're pretty good in soup. So what do we do when we're faced with a word problem and it wants us to divide one number by another, and at least one of those numbers has more than one digit? Well, other than panic, flip out, put a paper bag over our head, and hope no one finds us, what do we do? Well, let's use a relatively simple example so you don't have to resort to any desperate headbanging measures. Okay, so we're given the following problem. Right there. Maggie's getting married and has asked her 7 bridesmaids to help her make 136 papier-mâché cupids to hang around the reception hall. Her bridesmaids, who decide to stick by Maggie in spite of her tacky, horrendous idea, want to split the work evenly among them. How many cupids should each girl make? All right, well, first of all, papier-mâché cupids, really? We don't know this girl or her fiancé, but we have a feeling it won't last. Okay, so when presented with a word problem like this, the first thing we need to do is make sure we understand everything the problem is telling us. For example, we know we've got 136 cupids that have to be made, but how many worker bees do we have assigned to the project? Well, you can't just skim the problem and say 7. Maggie's asking her bridesmaids to help her make them, meaning we actually have 8 people on deck for this nightmarish activity. Okay, now that we understand the particulars, we need to set up the problem. How do we get to our answer? Well, we've got 136 cupids, and they need to be divided evenly between 8 people. So our problem should look like this. 136 divided by 8 equals our answer. Now it's just a matter of doing the math. 136 divided by 8 comes out neatly and evenly to 17. So each bridesmaid, plus our bride, needs to make 17 cupids. We can double check our answer by multiplying 8 by 17. See, 8 times 7 is 35, and that's 136, and that's it. You may have to deal with more complicated problems or bigger numbers, but the steps you need to take to arrive at an answer will always be the same. So the next time you're attempting to solve a tough algebra problem, just stop a moment and be grateful you're not creating winged, naked babies out of a sticky mixture of paper and glue. Things can always be worse.